Hey beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm coming to you guys looking like an African Alaja because I'm going to be reviewing the Arami Essentials African Black Soup, and I feel like this video has been highly requested. A lot of people have been asking me about this black soup in my DMs, in my comment section on videos, skincare videos. Like, people have been asking me, what's up with this black soup? Is it good? Is it going to fade my hyperpigmentation? Is it going to fade my dark spots? Is it going to brighten my skin? Is it going to make me glow? Is it better than the Fig Health Store black soup? So many questions, and I'm going to be covering everything in today's video. So if you are one of those people who have been requesting and asking about African black soup, or you're just really curious to know what this black soup does and if you should purchase it or not, then you want to make sure you watch this video till the end. Now, if you've been following me for the past, let's say 3 to 4 months now, you would know that I have been through a lot with my skin, and I've just been like going through a serious skincare journey that I've never necessarily experienced in the past. And I've been trying out so many products, including African black soaps, and I got the Arami Essentials African black soap. This is the Oinks polish. I got this about maybe almost 2 months ago, so I've been using this for like close to 2 months now. And in all honesty, I feel like this soap has played a really great role in getting my skin to where it is today. So this is the clarifying black soap, and it says it's for face and body, and the ingredients are raw African black soap, local honey, lemon, olive oil, rose water, and a blend of herbs. And it specifically says here that this is not suitable for sensitive skin, and I guess that is the reason why they have the Oinks lights. That one is the one that is suitable for sensitive skin. So in case you're interested in trying out the Arami black soap and you have sensitive skin, then I'd advise you to try out the Oinks light. Like, when I got it, I had active acne on my skin. Like, it was a lot everywhere. Like, I had active acne. So this really helped with my skin. There is no doubt about that. Now, first of all, it has like this African black soap scent. I don't think that they use like artificial fragrance in this, because it smells like earthy. It smells like African black soap, but then there is a mix of honey and lemon to it, but it's very faint. But like, the fragrance of the black soap is more prominent, so it kind of like has this balanced black soap, and I would almost say that it seems like it feels calming to me. So when I like just inhale this, I don't know, it just gives you that lavender calm vibe. I don't know if there's lavender in here. It doesn't smell like there is, but then like when you just smell the soap, it kind of like calms your senses to an extent, and I really like that. And it's not highly fragranced, if you're wondering. So if you are sensitive to fragrances, this is not fragranced at all. I don't think that they use like artificial fragrances in this, like I said, so that's not going to be a problem for you. As far as the texture goes, you can see what it looks like, and you guys can see that I've actually used up a lot. I have used up a lot from the soap. I just have a little left. Now let me tell you guys something, I do not use this as I would with a very big jar. As you can see, it comes in a really this is a 250 ml jar, and I would say it is small, to be honest. Like, the Alaroro in me will not allow me use this every day on my body. So I use this sparingly on my body because I have a body wash that I alternate with this, but on my face, this is the only thing I use on my face. It has become like my staple face wash, so I use this on my face morning and night, and that's the reason why I feel like it has really helped with my skin so far. Now, it has a pasty texture, but it's like kind of soft, so it's not like hard. It's very easy to scoop out, and it glides on well. It does lather, so a little bit goes a long way. Now, with regards to what it does, I would say that this soap has actually really helped with my hyperpigmentation and dark spots. And the reason is because when I started using this, like I said, I had like serious active acne all over my face. And with regards to fading like dark spots, I think that you need to give it time. It's not something that is going to like perform magic and just fade your hyperpigmentation in a day or two, but with like a month or maybe like 2, 3, 4 weeks, I think you'd start to see like difference and just gradual fading of your dark marks and hyperpigmentation. Now, I have actually read a couple of people saying that this black soap actually dries out their skin. For me, I did not experience that. So probably if you have dry skin, you might want to stay away from this, since the people who are actually complaining that it dries out their skin. But me, I have combination to oily skin, and that was why this was perfect for me. I did not experience any dryness. I did not experience any tightness. Now the way I use this, I'm sure you guys must have seen in a couple of my skincare videos, I actually apply it on my skin. I lather it up and then leave it on as a mask on my skin throughout my shower. So when I'm done with washing my body, then I rinse my face last, so it just gives it time to penetrate and just help activate the ingredients and just allow, give them like time to like work and just penetrate my skin better. So if you want to like get a maximum result out of your African black soap, I just advise that you use it as a mask, apply it on your skin for maybe like 3 to 5 minutes depending on how long your shower lasts, and then you rinse it up. It's just going to give it like more time to do the job, really. Now I do have one problem with this, just one problem actually with this soap, and I don't know if it is an oversight from Arani or if that is how all the soaps are. I don't know if it's just this batch or this one, but let me know if you've experienced this. Now it does have stones in it. I don't know, yeah, stones. I don't want to call them microbeads, they actually stones. It does have stones in it. Now when I started using it at first, like when I scoop it out and just apply it directly on my skin, I would feel some kind of like stone, like, so I don't know if it was from production or something, but you guys are leaving like little particles of stones in here, and that could actually hurt someone's skin. So I'd advise that if you want to use this, once you scoop it out, just try and like, you know, smush it all over your finger and just feel the texture, just mesh it all over your finger just to make sure that there are no stones in there before going in with it on your face. I have never heard anybody complain about stones being in this black soap, to be honest. I've watched a couple of reviews and I've read a couple of reviews. I've never heard, and that's why I'm saying I don't know if it is this particular batch of production or something, but that's really the only problem that I have with this soap. Other than that, I feel like it is a really, really good soap. Now, for those of you who were asking me, does it mean that I no longer recommend the Fig black soap? Fig is going to be a staple in my skincare routine forever. You guys should just know that. So if you want to get the Fig Health Store one, by all means do you. And if you want to get this one, but I'm just trying to give you like more options, because I feel like with skincare, it's really, really good to have alternatives to your favorite skincare products, just in case you're out of stock or they don't have them at the moment, or probably you don't have the money to buy them in case they're more expensive. It's always good to have like a flexible skincare routine that you can actually rotate through. I'm going to be making a video comparing some of like your favorite African black soap, maybe this one against the Fig one and like that, just so that it gives you like an insight on what I think when comparing both soaps and like brands together, basically. But this is actually a really, really good black soap. It does the job. It cleanses the skin. It doesn't dry out my skin. It helps to fade your dark marks with time. And you know, it's just a really, really basic black soap that I feel like anybody can use, especially if you have active acne. This is going to work wonders for you. So just in case you're one of the people who ask those questions, or just in case you're looking to try out black soaps, or you just want to know about the brand, this is what I think about the Arami Onyx Polish, and I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, you know what to do. Smash the like button, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in another video. By the way, let me know what other videos you would want me to film and what other products you would like me to review for you guys, because you know I got you always. Thanks for watching this video. I love you guys so much. Have a great life. Stay safe. Bye.